we already...
the dial on. It's a very nice dial. It's got some scratches on it from age. Make sure when you put the hands on that the hands do not rub on the face of this dial. Most of these dials are carved wood. That's what you see right here. This is a single
wag on a wall type German movement.
Came out of a grandfather, an American tall case clock, grandfather clock. Nice little movement. Count wheel, of course. Not sure if these bushings are factory standard, but they look real nice. Nice little movement. We'll have to take her apart and figure out what's stopping it from ticking. This is the type of movement that's got little hooks on it up on top here, and they're for the dial. These hold the dial on. Why, I can't reach that. Oh, I see. They just kind of zip in this way, and the dial is pegged in with these little nails sticking through it. The back plate is off right now, and someone did a really neat job of putting in some brass inserts, so machine screws actually hold the back plate in. This is the back plate for it. Standard German issue. Almost looks like a cuckoo clock kind of an arrangement. But better quality. Beautiful piece of wood. A couple of things that I've noticed on it. I'm not sure if I like this or not, but it seems to work just great. The count wheel's got quite a bit of play in it, but the count wheel just kind of goes along for the ride, and the sensor censors the deep slots, so that might or might not be okay. I already took the verge out of it, and another thing in typical cuckoo clock style fashion, it's got the little hanger for the pendulum. And it continues on to this wheel and then the escape wheel. So on a time side, all of the power goes through this bearing mostly. Less of it goes through the opposite side because, well, that's a. I guess it would be about kind of neat looking. It's not removable. It's actually nailed in there and peened over. On the inside of the movement, there's nothing we can remove, so it's a typical wooden movement type arrangement where they just install pieces with nails. That one comes around and it hits into that lever right there. 9, 10, 11, and then 12 o'clock. And this is 12 o'clock. So 1 o'clock is the one that doesn't have any pin at all, because all it has to do is to strike once and stop. The 2 o'clock has got this little obstruction there, so when the flag comes around, it hits into this little obstruction here, and it continues counting an extra one until it goes into the next slot. Okay, now that we got that all talked about to death, let's pop off this guy. Make sure you don't drop him. He'll break very easily. Okay, now what we need to do is to get all these wheels out of here so we can clean up all these bushing holes. Okay, this one gets put in there. I'm going to get my rack so I can take everything out. This nice little rack that I made. I'm not going to use it in the ultrasonic, but it was formed out of a piece of material you can buy at Staples that secretaries use, that A-frame to hold their papers in front of the computer. And I've just simply re-bent it. This is the top handle right here. There's the footy over there. And I have all these holes in here to capture the lantern pinions and the arbors. So we'll take the escape wheel. T1, T2. Escape wheel was T4. Here's T3. I'm wiping them off as we take them apart. That causes good oil that's supposed to be in the bushing to follow the dripping oil, and it actually creates a dry pivot hole. So be very careful about over-oiling. Over-oiling is not a good thing. You can actually cause a dry pivot by over-oiling. Okay, so we got this guy. Have anything else there? I'm gonna just keep everything inside the rack. Let's go ahead and take out the strike side
itself. Just like that.
You never know what you can use them for. It's quite incredible. This is good for fixing saddles, verge saddles. I took a piece of rebar and I cut a slot in it. This way I can push down on wheels that have to slide in a C-clip, and the C-clip fits right in to make the day go by better. Okay, now we're going to put T1 back in there. And why is it not working? That's because it's upside down. I'm not concentrating on a symptom and trying to find a problem that's causing that. I never do that. What I do is I look for problems for every single part that I touch. If I see anything like the shake on these guys or the tilt on these guys not being 100%, I fix it right away. I don't try to imagine that that's what the cause of the problem is. I'm not concerned with the cause of the problem. I'm concerned with this clock working for the next 10 to 20 years. In order to do that, I need to fix everything. And after I finish fixing everything, I'll probably have found the problem. But I won't know which one it was. I don't care which one it was. I just want to make the clock work. If I was to nitpick and look for a few days and test and try and test and try, that just takes way too long, and a customer wants his clock back. So the easiest thing to do is just simply overhaul the entire movement, and that's it. Everything is fine after that. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. This is 8 o'clock. Here it comes. Drops down, hammer releases, and now comes the half hour. We got everything timed when it was on the workbench just right. Now down below here we have the pendulum. It's not a very big pendulum bob, but I guess the wag on a wall doesn't really require it. If they were to put any more weight on that pendulum bob, it would probably interfere with the recoil escapement in trying to swing at that massive amount of swing there. So that's why they use such a light pendulum bob there. I mean, look at the length of that rod below the pendulum.
Stopping that from working.
So now every time I raise this, get you another view over here. And don't forget the close up. You notice that's just a sensor. It doesn't actually stop anything. All it does is sense the deep hole.
As soon as you can see everything put together, that is. And here's the wag on a wall clock. I've finished putting the dial on. It's a very nice dial. It's got some scratches on it from age. Make sure when you put the hands on that the hands do not rub on the face of this dial. Most of these dials are carved wood. That's what you see right here. This is a single piece of wood that's been carved. Not only does it have the this carved piece here for the calendar dial, but it's also curved. And I don't know if this picture will show the curviness of it. It's actually hollowed out. So be very careful when you're dealing with this. It's a single piece of wood. Yeah, we are ready.